Hey, Game Makers! Today, by popular request, I'll be showing you a few different ways to include DLC. That is, downloadable content. That is, extra stuff that, for whatever reason, wasn't in the main game, into your project. Now, there may be other ways of doing this, and if so, I don't know them. I'll be sharing with you the ways I came up with for my game to do it. And some tips that might help you along the way. In this video, we'll be going over the following. Unintegrated DLC, that is, doing everything manually and not using the Steam interface. A brief overview of doing it with the Steam interface, and some examples, tips, and things to keep in mind. I'll be going over how I did it specifically for my project, and then giving you a less convoluted way to do it yourselves. First, unintegrated DLC. What I did. In my game, I currently have three sets of DLC. Two costume packs, and a guidebook, all of which can be accessed within the game. Let's talk adding things like costumes to the game. This would include in-game items and basically anything you'll want to add to the inventory. We should make a quick list of things to do. Make the game acknowledge that the DLC is active, add in the DLC! For the DLC costumes in my game, I just used a map. The map runs at the start of the game, before the title screen. If the DLC pack is not installed, an event triggers on auto-run, and simply teleports to the next DLC check map, and ends at the title screen. Go into your game's data folder and make a copy of that map, changing the map name to mapxdefault.json. This is purely to ensure you have a backup of the original. Back in the game, we'll now turn that event off, or delete it, whichever, and create a new one. Now, the way I'm doing it in my game, I'm using Hime's Sync Switches plugin, which, among other things, allows you to save whether a switch is on or off upon opening the game. So what I did was have the event turn on a switch that says, DLC Pack X is in the game, and force a save to save it, and then continue to the next DLC maps all the way to the title screen. This means that any future time the game opens, it's already acknowledged that the DLC is in it. Go back to your map files and make a copy of this one, too, named mapxdlcwhatever.json. When you're done with this, make sure to set your map back to the default one. Put your mapxdlcwhatever file into a folder containing all your DLC resources, and remove the dlcwhatever from the name, so that it just reads as the normal map number. Now, the annoying part! For inventory and items, you have to add them to the database. I'd highly recommend adding the actual database inputs to the main game itself for several reasons, mostly relating to bug fixing and updating. Just assume you're going to have to update your database at some point. You will not want to be maintaining separate DLC database files. At this point, you just add. Go to where you want to add the DLC item, and do a quick if DLC switch is on, add item. In my game, this is done on a new game start, and also on load, as I wanted the player to be able to access them on existing save files. I'm personally using YIP utility events to do this, as it lets me run a common event on load. Lastly, if any graphics or other resources are needed, include blank placeholders in the main game! This is so if they're required to be loaded in-game, you can just add placeholders in the main game so you won't have to have multiple copies of your game data files to manage that are DLC exclusive. In my case, I did this so I could have everything set up in stuff like common events without breaking everything if the DLC was or wasn't there. Then you just lay out your DLC resources in their correct folders, and make up something like a .rar installer to add them into your game. TLDR, create base map, create add DLC map, create database entries in main game, set folders up to add the DLC map and resources, create an installer to add them all into the game, or give the player instructions. Quick things to note! You actually don't have to use plugins or things to do this like I did. If you want a DLC pack installed when you hit new game, you can just do the map add sequence at that point. You can make up an installed DLCs menu using choices or something like Yep's menu blah 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 blah. Or something like Yep's menu manager thing. It is awesome and I love it! instead of doing the map add sequence, you could much more easily just replace a map in-game for a spot where the DLC spawns. How you choose to have your DLC interact with your game is totally up to you. And these are just what I did, and some thoughts I had about doing it. Adding story DLC. I'll be honest, I haven't done that yet. But I did consider doing that for my game's epilogue quests. It has a series of short stories that take place after the game's finale, and I had initially intended them to be DLC in the original game. Technically, they were DLC in the original RMXP version of the game, and it operated in much the same way, just replacing or adding the map files needed. In my case, I just had a selector map menu that would get updated as I finished making the DLC, and the DLC installers would add all the updated data and the map and resource files. This gets a bit more tricky, as you likely don't want people who don't have the DLC to have access to the, say, maps and content without, you know, getting the DLC. So what do? Add in placeholder content. Mainly, if you plan to add in story maps to your game, have the main game hold placeholders. Same with data and the DLC story inputs. It's mostly a suggestion for your sanity of keeping things straight. This is especially important if you're planning on having multiple story DLCs that add new area content, as you'll want to make darn sure you have all your maps and things numbered correctly, as to not inadvertently overwrite something. True story, done that, been there, don't do it. Steam DLC. So everything I mentioned above, you can do as is. Steam will just automate the adding the files into the game process. For at least RMMV and MZ, there's a plugin called Greenworks that lets you add a Steam client interface commands into your game. This is not a tutorial in Greenworks. No. But I will show you how I used it. Let me start by saying, using Greenworks Steam commands makes everything easier. I did my above setup initially, because I was testing the DLC long before putting it on Steam for testing. So I wanted to give my debuggers access to it. I'll link Greenworks in the description. Essentially, you download the files, put them in the correct locations, and add the plugin in! First off, interfacing through Greenworks gives you access to this command. OrangeGreenworks.isDLCInstalled --? Can you guess what this is? You input the app ID of your DLC, and you throw it into a conditional branch and check if the DLC is installed. Much easier! No map finagling required! Now, my costumes were already set up to use the initial method, but I did use this for my guidebook. If EM2's guidebook DLC is installed, I have it set to set a switch. And if the switch is on, it shows up in the options screen! For this, I'm using Yep Options Core, which is another plugin that is much too in-depth for me to go over here. Greenworks is also how you do things like Steam achievements and other Steam commands. Steam automagically adds in the DLC you would have set up like we did above, and yeah, rinse and repeat.
I do understand, this is a bit very complicated.
And me explaining it like word salad probably doesn't help. DLC really is just a matter of making sure the game knows the DLC is in, and replacing the files. And there really are several ways of doing this that works best with whatever project you're doing. Whether you have access to an automated interface like Steam, plugins, or not. There very well could be a DLC plugin I don't even know about, mostly because I already had this set up from EM1's testing, so I just reused it and never had to look one up.
So I hope this helped you, and if it didn't,
well, I hope you had a fun however many minutes enjoying this video. If you want to see more cool things I did in my game, you can check it out on Steam, see the, like, what, 3 years worth of devlogs? Oh god. Or backlog through my Twitter to find all the weird, funny Mode 7 stuff I posted that one time. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later, gamers!